2010-0342. Parish President Report, Mr. St. Pierre.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. If you're not impressed with Mr. Jones Diaz's report after being on the job for just 2 months, it says a lot about it. I know in the interviewing committee, which Mario was the person in charge of the interviewing committee, along with myself, Timmy, and Rusty, we were really blown away with Jones' abilities and a dedication to helping people. And I really think she's going to bring the community service department to a level that this parish has never seen before. So, Joan, we count on you to do a lot of good things for the parish. Last week, we attended the St. Charles Hospital Emergency Department expansion groundbreaking ceremonies. This new 12,000-square-foot emergency department will facilitate shorter waiting times, increased patient privacy, larger rooms for caring of the patients, and includes advanced equipment. I think when's the completion date scheduled, Tim? About 1 year, I think it's about a year in the making, so something that the parish can look forward to. Also, we had an invitation from Waterford. Like Joan said, Doug's all over. They had their 25-year anniversary of the Waterford 3 nuclear power plant. Doug, appreciate the invite. You know, when I was on the police jury in the 1980s, I conducted the hearings for the nuclear power plant. At that time, nobody in St. Charles Parish even knew what a nuclear power plant was. The guy got up there and started talking about reactor rods, fueling rods, and it was like mind-boggling. But over the 25-year history of the plant, I don't think we've ever had an incident Waterford that I know of. So, Doug, congratulations on 25 years of good service to the parish, and we appreciate all those tax dollars you're bringing into the treasury. We also were glad to participate in the St. Charles Parish Rotary Club Alligator Festival. Beautiful weekend. Had over 16,000 people came through the gates, and people from all over, not only Louisiana. We had people from Canada, Russia. So it's quite a big event that the parish looked forward to every year, and it was a very successful event. The Trash Bash, which we had over 100 people participating in, was last weekend, and it was in conjunction with the Wetland Watchers Group. The grand opening event took place, and thanks to all those who helped organize the event. Of course, a special thanks to Barry Gilliatt, Milton Combe, and Earl Mathern for their dedication and involvement in the Wetland Watchers Park. Beautiful day, beautiful backdrop. Amanda Shaw played for 3.5 hours, had some great food out there, and we had, I would say anywhere, some 800 to 1,000 people showed up. And also like to thank Dow for contributing to the outdoor classroom. And if you hadn't been back there and seen it, it's a beautiful area. Only bad thing is getting back there, it's so dusty, so hopefully next year that the Corps has allocated some money to blacktop the road going back there. And we're not finished yet. There's a lot of more things we'll be doing back there. So it's a pretty exciting area. If you hadn't had time to see it, it's worth your while going back there and checking it out. This Thursday, United will be hosting their annual Battle for the Paddle event at the West Bank Park. It's from 3:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Come out and enjoy some great jambalaya and some gumbo. All you can eat for $5, so you can't get no better than that. Very excited. Last week, we were notified we got grants totaling $15.4 million from FEMA, which will help the parish upgrade and improve drainage infrastructures in Boutique, New Sarpy, Norco, St. Rose, Luling, and Bayou Gauche. The needed projects were well suited to the Hatteras mitigation grant purposes, which is to prevent potential flooding damage from the area's residents and businesses. And the projects that were awarded were the 80 Arpin pumping station, automatic bar screen cleaners and booty for $4 million, USARPI pump station, automatic bar screen cleaners and USARPI for $1.6 million, Engineers Canal station, automatic bar screen cleaners and Norco, $1.8 million, Diane Pumping Station, auto bar screen cleaners in St. Rose, $603,000. Eddie Arpin in Boutique, $2,967,000. Ormond Boulevard Canal Crossing Improvements, Industrial Hand, $2.1 million. Willowdale Box Culvert Improvement, $549,000. That's some grants that we applied for earlier in the year, and we've just been notified of, so that's going to be a big help to the parish. Also, as I stated in my last report, the parish will be holding its Info Tour from 8 a.m. to noon on October the 14th, 15th, with the East Bank tour on the west on the 14th and the West Bank tour on the 15th. This is a chance to tour and learn about our parish infrastructure and government buildings. Those interested in the tour may RSVP by calling 783-5182. That's 783-5182. And you can come out and take a visual tour at this address. And it's a great event that I think we offered to let the people see what exactly what your parish dollars are being spent on. And I'd like to thank all the people who came out and voted for our millage renewal this week. That it was the library millage, 911, and the road lighting millage, and that's good for another 10 years. So thanks to everybody that came out, even those that voted against it. You know, it's a shame we only had like 6,000 people came out of 32,000 voters. So, but that's government. So if you want to participate in government, you need to get out and vote. But thanks to all those people that came out and voted for this millage. And that includes my report, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Mr. St. Pierre.